In the last video, we have learned about how we can get the unique list from the channel. Like we got a distributor, export, and wholesales. So here you can see we are also having total revenue. So now the requirement is we need to sum up the total revenue for each distributor, right? So at the end we will have this list, and we need another column where it will be summed up all the relevant total revenue for every channel. So how we can do that? We need to go to the sales, and or we can go to sale 2, and we don't need now list, just remove it. And here we have to apply one a group by. We need to select this column channel, and then we have to click. There is one option here, group by. So in the group by option, we have to select, or if you haven't choose if you haven't selected the column channel, then you can change any column according to your requirement. So here we can choose channel, and now we need to write one suitable name for the column. So like we can write here channel sales, or channel grouping. And here we need to, and here we have to choose one operation. Here we have lot of operation like sum, average, mean, median. And for this example, we have to choose all rows, right? So because we need one table. Like if I say select static from this table where channel is equal to distributor, so we will get that behavior, all rows, and that's it. Column name of the column name on which we want to perform grouping, and then then you need to choose the name, and then the operation all rows. So with the passage of time, we will learn about all the other functions as well, but for this video we just need to focus all rows here and click OK. And here you can see we are again getting groups, like because the grouping was on channel. And then here you can see we are getting another column, and here you can see everywhere table is repeating. If you click here, and you will see the whole list of the table that belong to distributor. For example, if I click, there are two options. Either you can click on table, or either you can click beside this table. If you click beside this table, then you will see the result down here. If you click on the table, then the table that belong to that distributor, see here, this is the distributor, right? So how we can write the same thing in SQL? What is happening here? I have imported the same table in the SQL. So it's a saved order. So it's like select static from and channel is, for example, distributor, and where channel is equal to distributor. So here you can see we are getting 2510 rows for the distributor channel. And in the same way, we are getting distributor rows for the distributor, wholesale, and export. So we just need to click close here, and right now we are here. Okay, so in which column we are interested? We are interested in the column total revenue, right? Only one column we are interested in, only one column. We need to write one column so that we can get only total revenue here. So for this, we need to click on the add column, and then you have to go to the custom column here. And here you can write the name of the column, like a single column table. And here we have to write here one formula, like table dot select column, and then we have to provide one table, the channel grouping, and here we have to write which column we need. So it is total revenue. So that's it. So we just need to click OK. So we are getting error, table dot table select column. So there is something wrong. So we just need to delete this head column, and then we again have to click custom column, and we need to write here single column, for example, and the name will be, the formula will be table dot select column, and see, we have written two times table. So we need to delete the first table, and this table, this select column function needs two parameters. The first one is the table, which is channel grouping here. In which column we are interested? Is it total revenue? Total revenue, this one. And that's it. Click OK. And here you can see we are getting a new column, and here again there is table. So if you click here, so here we are getting only one column that contain total revenue, and we are interested in we want to sum up all these numbers and want to display here. So let's try to write one more column here, custom column, and we can just write the name revenue. And here we have to write, let's have a look if there is any function available in table. Table.sum. See, we don't have sum function. Aggregate table column. Okay. And here if we provide single column, and click OK. Aggregate table dot. Okay, again there is some problem. We click custom column and revenue. Table dot aggregate table column, and we need to just be careful. You have to write the proper name. So table dot aggregate column, and then we have to provide the first parameter will be table, and a column as a text. Okay, so this is the name of the table, single column, and then the name of the column will be total revenue. So this formula will not help us because according to the documentation, aggregate table column into multiple columns containing aggregate values for the table. So this is not a useful function at the moment. So we can delete it. And here we can write one more function. So we need to click here. We need to write revenue. And then we have to write a table.max. And here table.max. So this is a function, this one. And the name of the table is single column. And then we need to provide the column name. This is total revenue. That's it. And click OK. So here you can see we are getting a record. So if you click here distributor, and then the maximum value is 78550, right? So again we are having issue, we are not able to fetch the value from the table here. So how to convert this record stuff to the table so that we can get one value here, we will see in the upcoming videos. So in this video we right till now we have learned that how we can apply different functions to achieve our required result, but still we are not able to get our result here. So what we can do is we can provide one list here, just need to delete, and we are here only the channel grouping and we are getting all the columns here. So now what we can do is we just need to click custom column, and name of the column will be single column, and here we have to provide one list. We need to create one list, right? So in the previous video how we had created list, we just need to click this channel grouping, this is the table, it is returning one table, and then we again need to write bracket and the name of the column. The name of the column was it is a total revenue. This one, click OK. So here you can see we are getting list. So this list contains every wholesale is having one list and the export is having one list. In the prior steps we did we get this thing with the help of single select column function. So now we have list, and then we can add the final step here, custom column, and here we have to write revenue, sum of revenue, and here we have to write function of the list.sum. So we need to remove, so list.sum, and then list.sum need only one list. So the single column is returning a list to us. We just need to close here and click OK. So here you can see we are getting the total sum of revenue for the distributor, wholesaler and export. So we don't need these two columns, we just need to select these two and click delete, remove columns. So now we are getting our result here. And if you want like the min and max and other thing, so you can do that easily with the help of list, because we are having many functions. Like if I show you here, so here you can see we are having list dot min, list dot max, and there are different list functions. Okay, so we will try to cover as much as we can according to the situations. So now you can practice. If you need a data set for this video, you can go to the learnducks.com, where you can download different data sets, and you can also learn about different topics. So, and please subscribe our channel if you like our videos. Thank you.